Hey guys, Mantis here, coming with the new VOD review. This player here, IIMX, he's level 26, new player, wants to learn about jungle. And it seems like this game, 062313, seems like all of his lanes did pretty bad, 5-4, and he's the only one positive. This kind of stuff happens when you play jungle, so just kind of get used to it. But this doesn't happen every game, obviously, right? So let's just get into the game. Now, first thing I can say is that although defending is very, very good, you need to defend multiple angles. So making sure you defend this is really important. So even though there's two guys or three guys here, it's actually not that good, because if they do invade, Lux, Anivia, Zin, and they start that snowball, you guys are done, right? So just keep that in mind. When your teammates are walking around here, you can definitely see which path they're taking, and then try to take the other path so you can have all the entrances covered. And most of the time, like, what junglers do is they go here, they place the ward, they base, and then buy a red trinket or the sweeper, the sweeper, right? So Yone has the Orca lens. That's what I meant. Anyways. Moving on ahead, here's the clear. Lots of different clears you can do on Kayn. You can start Raptors, you can start with the Leash, you can start Wolves, you can start Blue. Really depends on the jungle matchup. Now, I think your ward is up. I'm not sure if you placed it. But you can oftentimes place a little defensive ward here or here, just in case Xin Zhao comes. Because usually Xin Zhao likes to invade, but it's hard to know if he's going to invade you unless you're paying attention to bot lane to see if they leashed or not. That's a more advanced concept with like camera control in the early game when you're clearing. But yeah, there's always a chance that junglers like Xin Zhao, Lee Sin, Pantheon will come try to invade you. Good escape. Yeah, not bad. Stuff like this happens. Handled it pretty well. Now go bot side for the jungle clear. So far, not too bad. I'm liking it. Here is just like he flashed your spell, right? But then you also missed your W. You just need to play more. You'll eventually hit it, right? Like that's just how it is in League. Like you just get more reps in, play more. Eventually, you'll be able to hit it like 80% of the time. Xin Zhao showed top, so this is like an important concept for junglers. Just when the enemy jungler shows top, it's a good opportunity for you to look. Okay, he's at 114 HP. His Gromp is up. Crab is up. So what's my next move, right? As Kayn, right? Well, the best move right now is to actually just go up here and then eat the Gromp. And if it's not there, it's all good, but you're still playing for that, right? I'm pretty sure it's up. Back to blue. So yeah, you should go up to the Gromp, eat the Gromp. Don't go for the Wolves because it takes too long. But after you eat the Gromp, then you go for the Scuttle Crab and hold your Smite on the Gromp until you're in trouble. Like you see Xin Zhao or see someone toss a spell, and that's when you use the Smite. Because you want to save the Smite for Crab, because if Xin Zhao respawns, sees that his Gromp is gone, he's immediately going to try to play aggressive in the river or try to look for you. So I'm letting you know right now that's going to happen. Okay, so this is a very good gank, But Yone was sleeping, right? But also you're sleeping a little bit too, so I'll tell you why. So here, you actually just wait. You even walk up here, and you want to wait. And the reason why is because you have to understand what Yone does, right? Blue. So after two Qs, he gets a knockup, right? So look at your gank. He has zero stacks on his Q. He has one stack right now. He has one stack on Mortal Steel, and you're already here, right? So imagine if his Mortal Steel is at 3, you're here, boom, it's a knockup, you get the flash. His flash is probably maybe even on cooldown, but you get it, right? That's what you want to be looking for all the time with your ganks. You want to play more patient. Right now it's too impatient. But so far, nice, I like it. So now, it's better to path to Wolves, Gromp, and perhaps even look top here. You really want to be efficient with your time and your EXP, right? Like, when you're walking around like this, looking for the next play, it's a little bit forced. And you're missing out on gold and EXP that you can be getting, right? So even if you hit this and you hit this, right? You back and then you go back and go to red as it spawns. Try to get that good timing, right? When you're ganking a lane and there's only one guy here, bot lane, and the other guys are right here, the chances of it is working is actually pretty low. And I've experienced this a lot where the jungler tries to force a 2v2 without the ADC or the support. And what happens is that they often get in a negative spot. You know, they have to burn flash or they die. It just doesn't work out as well as it should be, right? And also, when you do this gank, you have to look at the minions here. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 minions, right? And they all deal damage, right? So 29 for the range, right? You can just do the math, right? It's like, it's just too much damage. All the damage these minions do is almost half a champion's damage, right? So this gank is not that good, right? And all the while, you could have been halfway to level 6 right now instead of being almost level 4. I'm a solo queue player, so I'm gonna always give you advice on how to climb solo queue, and the best way to climb solo queue is to be efficient as a jungler. So here's a play where you get invaded. Yeah, I can tell you what to do here. So this seems minor, but it's major. So everything so far right here is good. Using that W on the camp is fine, 100%. Now E overing the wall is good as well. This is where the mess up happens, right? The camp, you have to make sure the camp will always be hitting Xin Zhao instead of you, right? This is gonna be the difference in the fight here. So look closely. Q, yeah, nice damage there, and then the red buff strikes you there, red buff strikes Xin here, I believe, it hits Xin here, and then I think it hits you again here, yeah, and how close it is on Xin Zhao is about, 100 HP, 86 plus 86 was at 140, so you would have killed them if you played this properly, right? So this is a big one right here. It's small, but it's like, okay, once you know it and understand it and you start playing for it, a lot of better things could happen. So yeah, top lane died, bot lane died. It happens, right? He's got to play to win, right? Mid lane die, yeah. It gets tough. When you're in situations like this in League, it gets tough. And there's not much I can say other than you have to play perfect in the early game. Because you want to be 2-0 or 3-0 and you can win. But if you're 0-1, 0-2 and you're trying to rely on someone else to help you win, it's never going to work, right? You can just always do it by yourself, right? So here's the gank again where his cooldowns, his spells are on cooldown and you're charging in like a bull. Once you see it, you'll understand it, right? You have to go the long way and you have to let his skills come back, right? And that's I don't know if you use a camera, but you gotta use a camera to look when you play, right? And then, of course, it might be obvious to me, but you have to go the long way. Or you can go the long way. And going the long way, pincers Lux. So yeah, if you do go the long way, you kind of pincer her, right? So it's just overall, it's a better move overall. Something definitely keep in mind. What else here? She dies top. And then here you're too low HP. Nice, very nice dodge there. I like that. That's a mechanics. Actually, mechanics might be able to get you a kill here. Very good, very good. That's actually very nice. I applaud you. You can get a double here. You got a Q over. You can E as well, but it was on cooldown. That's fine. Get the kill back off. So far, yeah, not bad. Good start, good fundamentals. Okay, cast a curse, but you just, like, how much gold do you have right now, right? This is something that you always have to wonder when you're playing jungle, is that right now you're sitting on 1,000 gold and you're at half HP. It's obvious better just to spend your gold, come back, and then you'll hit everyone harder and your chances of killing them will be even higher, right? Like, you just got to kill bottom. You guys were like fighting all the way up here. You went to clear this camp, you know, just take the time to back, right? You don't need to do this, right? So, and this is like something I noticed about your play, is that you're forcing too much, especially when the minion wave is getting pushed in like this. When it's getting pushed in like this, you never want to force, right? It happens. But now it's like, okay, we're 1-6. How are we supposed to win, right? It's like, there's not much you can do when it's this bad, when it gets this bad. Big wave here. So situations like this, it's like you gotta use your camera, right? And if you ever see another one of my replays, I'm gonna be talking about this all the time. And for example, like even me, my camera is ally one is X, I mean ally Y is Z, ally two is X, ally three is C and it's V, right, on the keyboard. And then usually it's F1, right? F1 and F2, but then I never press those buttons. I never ever press those buttons, so I change it to the Z, X, C, and V. And it's just something that you just have to start doing, right? Because if you're clearing Gromp at higher ELO instead of ganking, then you won't climb. And everyone will start flaming you because you're not actually paying attention to the map. Because this is a free kill, but then you're focusing on Gromp. But then you just gotta like do the math, right? So how much is Gromp worth? How much is killing Hecarim worth? And how much is this wave worth? And it'll come. You know, like, you just have to practice and play and get used to using your buttons. It's a really important aspect of the game that a lot of players miss out on. And like sometimes for even years of playing, some player could be in Platinum for maybe 5-6 years and they don't even use the cameras. So the sooner you get busy with your cameras, the faster you'll have more success climbing in the jungle. Support, mid lane, basically every role, maybe ADC, not as much, but ADC as well. Yeah, see, at this point, it's clear that this player Lux is better than Yone, and you can't really do much about it, right? Like, he's getting his ass whooped right here, right? So again, you can't really do much about those situations. You just have to accept it and try to make the best out of it. And make sure you have an Oracle Lens so you can sweep for the wards. And then try your best to play around cooldowns. Like, he's not even walking up to alt, right? This Yone, he's kind of... I don't even think he knows you're coming for a gank. So now that I'm thinking like that, if he doesn't even think that you're ganking, you could ping, right? Ping, ping, ping on away. But he's going to be like, I'm at 200 HP, it doesn't work, it'll never work, blah, blah, blah. But, like, this is just the situation, right? Yeah, now even Xin Zhao can invade you here now as well. They just killed one of you guys. Okay, nice, nice. I want to check your bushes a little bit more when you're clearing, though. Especially when your bot laner dies to jungle gank. Fine. I'd think about backing soon, but clearing that's really good. You don't need to go for this, to be honest. I meant the dragon, but the kill was nice because she was mispositioned, right? But when you're taking dragon, you really have to think about, where are my allies? Where are they? And do we have wards, right? Because look at the wards they have, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. They have 4 wards, fully warded. They know exactly where you guys are, or at least 2 of you. And they're comfortably taking Drake, right? And then on your side, we have no vision. My teammates are here and here. Really, there's no business being here, right? Because if you do die and you're 3-0, that's a bounty. If you die, you're 4-0, that's a bounty. Now they win, right? And games are like this thin, you can't really afford to mess around, right? But like, it's good that you got the kill, but I'm telling you, better players, higher elo player will not position there. They'll position a lot differently and punish you way harder. You just can't be here. There's no reason to be here. You need to go farm your other side of your jungle. So if you like think about all the time from here all the way to when you decide to back, you know, that's a good portion of time that could have been used for something else, right? Obviously it's farming, right? But it's hard to find the balance, for sure, and you'll get it as you continue playing. Okay, don't be afraid. Like, playing aggressive is good. I don't know if you know, but you do have Gore Drinker, and he doesn't even have his thing, right? His mythic. So I'm liking this. Play aggressive, why not? Okay, a little bit of a misplay with your Q, but like I said, it's just execution, more reps, you'll get there. Can't get really mad at that. Could I use a Guard Drinker too? You actually need to be using a Guard Drinker. I think you might have been able to turn that fight, but I'm not sure. I'm not sure that. And then again here, I know you're pretty low right now, but there is opportunities that you're missing out on because you're taking that Gromp, right? Now it's too late, right? Now you go and he kills you. Oh. But I hope you get what I mean, right? I hope you do get what I mean. Like, this is like a doomed game, right? And sometimes you just have to go for the play, and I understand that. And that's what you did, so I respect that. And aside from here, I can continue watching, why not? I like to really pay attention, focus on the early game, because I feel like that's the place where most players make the most mistakes, and you can improve them easier. It's a little sloppy right now, right? People are dying like 3, 4, 5 screens away from each other. While this guy is like getting pushed here, right? But like it's just the nature of the ELO, right? You want to be the guys who are 15 against the guys that are 5, right? Easy, nice. Nice kill. Good mechanics, yeah. I like your game mechanics. Obviously, you can work on them, but, like, nobody plays perfect. I go for the MF here, yeah? he hesitated a little bit, but it's hard to see that play in live. You're pumping. You guess FF? That makes sense. GG. Hopefully these tips help. And good luck on the riff.